Hi, I'm Patrick. This is the Ask Patrick series. Today's question is by Siddhant. The question is, should the people in the second and third slot know and ask the pattern from the people from the earlier slot? I mean, normally what happens in the exam is people write the paper in the first slot. Slightly unpredictable because we don't know number of questions. When they come out, then the people from the second slot go, and then the people from the third slot go. So the question is there any advantage for people from the second and third slot to know the paper pattern before they go for the exam? And you need to be careful, there are advantages and disadvantages. So know the advantages and skip the disadvantage. So I'll tell you a few advantages as far as knowing the paper pattern. One is you know the number of questions, because normally number of questions across slot remain the same. So last year, for example, in CAT 20, when people went in the first slot, they didn't know the number of questions. But when people in the second slot, third slot ask the people in the first slot, the number of questions were the same, including the breakup, how many RCs, how many non-RCs. That basically helps you to plan the paper better. So when you're going for the examination, you at least have a mental framework saying that this is a breakup of the questions and I can accordingly attempt it. Okay, that is the one definite advantage which is there. Second, maybe the type of question. For example, the four variable Venn diagram had come in the first slot, did come in the third slot. Not the same question, but type of question. So if you know the type of question, something which is new, which you don't know, maybe you can prepare for that and go for the exam. That was one advantage of previous in the later slot, because in the first slot, four variable Venn diagram had come. So people in the later slot could prepare for the four variable Venn diagram. And actually those came in the other exam. It should not have, but it had come in the next slots and they prepared and went for the exam. That advantage. So I definitely recommend people to understand the pattern of the paper before going for the exam. Disadvantage is regarding the difficulty level. When people from the first slot go in and come out, they talk about a difficulty level of the paper. That is subjective. What one person find easy could be tougher and vice versa. So if you try to predict a difficulty level of the paper based on the previous slot, it could backfire. Because I've seen a lot of times people in the first slot say that the paper is maybe tough, but paper may not be so tough and maybe you gotta solve more questions. Or vice versa, people in first slot say, oh, the questions are moderate level, you can solve it. But actually in the second slot, it turns out to be tougher in the first slot. And you get stressed saying that, oh, people in the first slot solve more questions than I couldn't solve, and that could lead to more stress. So one thing that you should be careful about is the difficulty of the paper. Take with a pinch of salt. Don't completely believe with the difficulty of the paper, because that could vary across slot. You can understand with regards to pattern of paper, know it, help you to plan the paper, but not maybe with a difficult level of the paper. Okay. I hope this helps. Maybe come across in more detail in terms of what you need to do about second and third slot people with regards to the information that you should gather from the first slot. We'll come up with a detailed video on that. Hopefully that should help you to prepare. Thank you.